Recent social and economic studies are based on game theory, but in fact, theory of games interesting and quite useful for any person not necessarily a scientist. The fact is that the game theory comes into your life you may not even notice with. When you drive a car to get somewhere, you're forced to consider decisions of other people. How exactly? You need to know where you can go and where you can't, because of traffic jam. But what is a traffic jam? Traffic jam appears when a lot of people decide to use the same road. They decided to go there for themselves, and you, whether you want it or not, have to consider this in your own movements. If you are considering the traffic jam, you can go around it. Otherwise, you go straight. Game theory is everywhere around us, and we know one of the most important paradoxes. People do not coordinate with each other and optimize their decisions on their own. As a result, we often get situations when everyone loses. In June 2000, London Millennium Footbridge was opened. But a few minutes later, as soon as the first pedestrians stepped on aluminum construction, the bridge went in waves like it made of paper. Some people even felt sick, rocked, and this chatter could not be stopped. At first, the engineers decided the problem was the number of people, but next day they put small groups of people and everything repeated. This was surprising because the bridge could hold a load for 1,000 times more. Everyone remembered the story of Tacoma Narrows Bridge, which behaved in exactly the same way. Fortunately, not a single person was harmed. Access to the bridge in London was closed. Not the air, not the water flows were not the reason what was happening. The problem was in pedestrians. Designers did not take into account how the bridge will respond to the steps of all people at once. It seemed that each person individually creates imperceptible vibrations when he walks along the bridge. But if at least part of the vibrations coincides, one catastrophe becomes possible for all. Now imagine that the same thing does not happening with the bridge, but with the largest economy of the planet. The same resonance of seemingly independent waves led to the crisis of 2000s. Firstly, it happened in USA and then by a chain reaction throughout the world. But that is another story. Concrete example can be given when the road system is structured as follows. Couple of roads there, stable traffic on them, people need to come from here to there and back. We have complete traffic, and in a certain place we have a traffic jam. The authorities decide to build new road connecting these two points, but density of traffic increases as well as increases the traffic jam. So everyone in this case travels for longer time as before. This is paradox, isn't it? But we can reverse this situation. In New York's 42nd Street have always been many traffic jams. This is the heart of Manhattan at the intersection of Times Square and Broadway. People even made phenomenal musical film about this street. It won 2 Oscars, and a copy of this film stored in the National Library of Congress. In 90th year, the authorities finally decided to close this cult street. Many citizens were sure that transport collapse would occur. Everyone was waiting for disaster. Finally, they got less traffic jams in that area as before. How could it be? This is absurd. How can the appearance of new road affect traffic and the time to come from point to point increases? It turns out that we're not calling up to each other and we are not coordinating our decisions. Everyone's trying to choose the optimal path without considering negative consequences of other people's choose. So if I choose this path, I'm increasing the traffic jam here, in this place. Everyone makes the same decision to come to this place and increases finally the traffic jam. As a result, total travel time increases as well. Let's consider some other example. Prisoner dilemma is not difficult to understand. Even if you don't know the math, imagine that you need need to get from point A to point B, but not go directly. Journey time will always take 20 minutes. The time of driving depends on traffic density as well. Emphasize right away that this particular part of the path will always be more attractive. So the question is, how long it will take for 200 drivers to travel this distance? Since there is no more attractive route, drivers will be distributed normally, which means that the second part of the distance will take 10 minutes for everyone. So under normal conditions, you and others will spend 30 minutes. Now we're going to add only one road. What will change? Each driver, including you, will go along the most advantageous path for you personally. Indeed, instead of previous 30 minutes, you can drive faster. Problem is that others think the same way. It's easy to calculate that everything will be exactly the opposite. Instead of 20 minutes driving, you will drive twice as long, which means 40 minutes. You're going to lose your time. And this is an example of paradox. Dietrich Bryce found it. Game theory allows you to make decisions based on the interests of all members involved. Sometimes these will be not the best solutions, but game theory will be able to predict situations when without intervention there will be complete collapse, or vice versa, to describe some situations in which intervention is not necessary. You always need to understand which side you are playing on, because game theory is a science about society.